everybody hear me?
What?
Well, I am happy to announce that I have finished my Christian short film. Well, technically, it's a Christian feature film now.
YouTubers can't make good movies.
Hey, at least it'll be better than the Smosh movie.
That's your bar?
So my Christian film deconstructs the Christian movie genre as well as Hollywood movies in general. It blends reality and fiction with no clear distinction between the two. Rather than beating you guys over the head with messages, I decided to hide the theology within the subtext of every scene instead. That way, you can analyze each scene for a deeper meaning. So without further ado, here is my Christian feature film, Lukewarm Atheist.
All my life I've been an atheist because there just wasn't enough proof for an existing God. But this is the story of how I found out that there is a God. Hey, I got a question for you, buddy. If God's not real, then how do fidget spinners work? Checkmate.
No, I can't do that. Murder's wrong.
Oh, Punky. Murder is just a very twisted art genre. You can use whatever tools you want. And their body is your canvas.
What the heck? That's messed up. You sound like Ted Bundy. Go away, Satan.
Okay, fine.
Gosh, that was way too dark for a Christian film.
But if you ever need me, give me a call. It's a 3-digit number. You know it.
Yeah, I'm not gonna give you a call.
Dude, that was stupid. Here's a question. What do you think real atheists are gonna think of your movie?
I have a hunch. Yeah.
Yeah, that's not gonna happen.
Yes, it will.
No. Fit, you don't get it. The only way to convert an atheist with a Christian movie is by making it safe and inoffensive. I'm gonna claim that my movie was made for atheists when I'm clearly pandering to Christians by making it safe and inoffensive. It's gonna work. There isn't a single atheist who is going to feel the Holy Spirit from your Christian movie, okay?
It's gonna work.
Okay, whatever. Let's just talk about how your Christian movie is different from all the other ones. For example, most Christian movies have predictable stories. Your Christian movie has no story. It's awesome.
Thanks. I just complimented myself for those who didn't catch it.
Although, I will say, just a little bit of criticism. Some of the hidden themes in your movie were a bit questionable.
What do you mean?
Well, for starters, your movie is clearly anti-establishment. Next time you make a Christian movie, maybe don't shove your anarchic agenda into it.
No, dude, okay. There is nothing in my Christian movie that parallels myself, my life, or my opinions in any way.
Dude, I'm going home.
Hey, what? Why?
I'm gonna go home and do my testimony. That way the movie can end and we can get started on Weed Whacker or whatever your next movie is. I really hope that was a firework.
Okay. I guess, yeah, you can go do that.
Hey, are you the one that made the movie?
Yeah.
Hey, I loved your movie. It was just like a God's Not Dead. Great job.
Now, let's give this movie a forced happy ending like every other Christian movie, despite the fact that this entire movie was leading up to an anti-character arc, one where I wouldn't change at the end. I am going to force a happy ending for the sake of making the audience and Reese's mom feel comfortable, even though it won't make any sense to someone who's actually read a screenplay writing book and knows you can't just have a happy ending come out of nowhere if the entire story wasn't leading up to it. But making a Christian movie isn't about following the rules of filmmaking. It's about spreading the gospel, not about making art. So let's contradict all the foreshadowing in this movie and just force a predictable, happy ending. God, this is my testimony. Within a couple of months, my personality has truly gone to the dogs. Everybody knows me as a dogmatic minge bag who mocks anyone with a different opinion. I may be using all these big words that I only have a vague understanding of, but I promise you I am not that smart. I once called myself a pseudo-intellectual, thinking that pseudo was another word for advanced, because I was a pseudo-intellectual. Anyways, not only have I indulged in pride, but I have also indulged in lust, gluttony, wrath, greed, sloth, and envy. A whole lot of envy. That's where all my vitriol comes from. It comes from the fact that all these people that I deem as untalented get more famous than me when they just started, while I've been making videos for 7 to 8 years. But regardless, I need to let this anger go. My fame-hungry attitude is killing me on the inside. Lord, help me lose my desire to be famous, and help me to be happy with working in retail for the rest of my life instead of Hollywood. Lord, help me give up on my dreams so I can work for somebody else who didn't. I am so tired of being a tortured artist who blames you for his inner pain and lack of recognition. It is completely my fault that I haven't found any mainstream success at all. Thank you for blessing me with a talent that I will happily use to edit wedding videos instead of my own stuff for a living. I love you, God. I've tried everything else, and now the only option left to fill the empty void in my soul is religion. Amen.
I don't understand. Why don't I feel happy? I just got baptized. Why don't I feel better? It's like while I was getting baptized, I was like on this high, and everybody was cheering for me, and I felt like I had genuinely changed, but like, now that some time has gone by, I realized
that baptisms don't magically change you. You have to do the change yourself. Baptisms are symbolic. They're meant to symbolize your commitment to Jesus. But see, wait, so you're telling me I have to do the change myself? That I actually have to try to get better? Baptisms don't just magically change me? I just feel lost. I am so sorry if you wanted this movie to end happy. But the thing is, most Christian movies are very serious, yet always have a happy ending. I wanted this Christian movie to be comedic, yet have a sad ending. To subvert everything that a mainstream Christian movie tries to be. I wanted Lukewarm Christian to be the exact opposite of what every single Christian movie tries to be. And I absolutely refuse to give this movie a happy ending for the sole purpose of making the audience and Reese's mom feel comfortable. Because that's insincere. Like, go back and rewatch the movie. There's tons of foreshadowing leading up to an anti-character arc. Baptisms can't change you. That was a cop-out character arc. It wasn't real. Baptisms cannot change you. You have to do the change yourself. I'm sorry if this wasn't the message that you wanted to hear, but like, not everything's just gonna magically get better after you're saved. At least not immediately. You gotta do the work. You gotta walk uprightly. You gotta do the work, dude. Or lady, both genders applied. And yes, I said both, meaning two. If you aren't willing to do the work to have a relationship with Christ, then you will continue to sink, literally and metaphorically. But even though baptisms don't magically change you, and you have to do the change yourself, they are still important. Now, you guys may not like the grim, realistic ending that I'm about to give you, because you don't like being reminded of reality when you're watching a movie. You like watching movies to escape reality. But I'm gonna give it to you anyways. We all need to come to grips with reality at some point.
Even though I accepted reality, I became content because I was free.
Revelations 3:16. So, because you are lukewarm, neither hot nor cold, I will spit you out of my mouth.
I'm Reese Thorne, and I'm the writer and director of this Christian short film you're watching. Now,
I wanted to do a little Bible lesson. Now, I am fully aware that adding this segment in ruins the flow of the story, which I am fully willing to do as long as you guys learn about the Bible. The verse we're going to be learning about today is Lance 2:10, "Thou shalt not let fit leave church." Now, this verse is very important because it forwards the plot. It is also important because in no circumstance should you let fit leave church. If you feel that God is telling you to not let fit leave church, and you let him leave anyway, that is sin. Now, although I did have to lie to convince him to go to church, and lying is a sin, but I lied for Jesus. Now, once you've turned to Lance 2:10, we can read the verse together. "Thou shalt not let fit leave the church." The Darby Bible translation reads, "Thou shalt not let thy friend leaveth thine church, or Lord Almighty will unleash his wrath upon thee." The Young Literals translation reads, "Thou shalleth not letteth thy friendeth fit leaveth thine church, or Lord Almighty will unleasheth his wrath upon thee." If. And that's your Bible lesson for today. Enjoy the rest of the film. Now, if you're going to make a Christian short film, you need to follow the Christian movie guidelines, which include no language, no nudity, and no violence, the only exception being Passion of Christ. And your Christian film must also carry Christian values, it must be uplifting, and it cannot contain any horror elements.
Are you a Christian who likes drinking coffee? Well, do we have the product for you! Go Away Satan Mugs! These ceramic mugs are sure to keep the enemy away while you're drinking coffee, milk, water, juice, and even ketchup! Oh yeah! What are you waiting for? The second coming of Christ? Pick up yours today at usable.spreadshirt.com.
Was that a YouTube ad? Was that a YouTube ad? What? What? Oh! Oh! Christian consumerism! Kill it!
Huggy? I hereby declare you grounded with the maximum sentence of 2 weeks!
No!
Yes.
Committing suicide is a good way to ruin every chance for anything to ever get better in your life. And believe me, it does get better. It always gets better.
Let's rewind it.
And believe me, it does get better. It always gets better.
Oh, man. That's comedy.
I'm so sorry. Not because she had to move in with her aunt, but because she had to move to Iowa. Don't worry, there's some fun stuff in Iowa.
Hey, Keaton, I bet you won't eat this. Do it if you're bad.
Maybe I'm really bad.
I'm extremely talented.
Let's rewind it.
And I think I'm extremely talented.
Send me down there!
Okay, just close your eyes and repeat after me.
Make a statement.
Was Mega Steak Man just too nice to say no? Oh man, I love this guy. I wish he still uploaded though. Okay, alright. Oh! Oh, this is my favorite one!
I like that. that effect. Need that effect there. Are you a Mega Man that needs a fireball? I shot one.
I'm Zelda from Lixus.
This is all you will get. Do you think you know what is real?
Do you think you know what is real?
He's got a point. Do you think you know what is real? Because I don't even know anymore. Embracing the absurd isn't working.
Do you think you know what is real? Let's test out.
Yuzuvil is the slow process of a madman going down a path of self-destruction. Watch as he dissociates himself from reality by cracking meta-jokes and breaking the fourth wall. Watch him slip into several different identities as he loses touch with his main one. Watch him as he becomes stuck between fantasy and reality with no clear distinction between the two. Experience an exclusive existential nightmare right in front of your eyes in the name of comedy. This is an introspective movie disguised as a Christian film. Look beyond the absurdity, and the dark philosophy of this movie will start to show.
The sacrifices I've had to make, I just couldn't say no. I'm in debt.
It was at that moment that I realized this movie isn't an autobiography. It was a psychodrama.
Oh, Fit, what's up?
I didn't think Reese was gonna let you come over here anymore.
Yeah, he doesn't really know I'm over here right now, to be honest. He thinks you're a bad influence on me.
Oh, he's not wrong.
No, Reese is just a little overprotective, a little overbearing. He's like an overbearing Christian parent, except he's not my dad. Well, actually, he might be, since he created me. Or, more like I am Reese. I don't know.
Fit, are you okay?
No. I think I might be living in a simulated reality. I don't think I'm real. I don't think you're real. I think you might just be an actor. Correct me if I'm wrong. I don't know who I am. I don't know if I'm Reese or if I'm Fit. Like, I don't know if I'm more Fit than I am Reese or if I'm more Reese than I am Fit. Am I going insane? Am I going clinically insane? Am I going insane? I realize everything is meaningless. Everything is meaningless! Because I know I'm not real. I know they're not real. So, who cares? Is this like The Matrix? Is this like The Sims? You know, like the computer game that my grandma used to play? You don't know my grandma, but I do. Is that cat right there even real? I don't know. Do I sound insane to you?
You're not real, I'm real.
Are you high? Are you drunk? Did you take your medicine today?
No, no, and no.
Okay, I'll see you later. Can't help me. Get out of my head, Reese! Get out of my head, Reese! No, you're in my head, Reese! Get out of my head, Reese! Get out of my head, Reese! Open that, I didn't pay for it. What are you looking at? If you don't stop staring at me, I'm gonna grab the nearest object. Now I'm gonna paint the floor red. Then I'm gonna buy a couple trash bags.
and I'm gonna take you for a ride. And then I'm gonna take a shovel, and I'm gonna feed the worms.
What happened? I blacked out for a few seconds.
Hey guys.
Hi there.
Well, did you guys know that I'm making a Christian short film?
Not at all. Really?
Yeah, do you two want to be in it?
Can you think of any, like, methods? Any long-term distance methods?
We could video chat.
Oh, when do you want to film this?
We could do it right now.
Here, I got my camera right here. Okay, hold on.
Action. Hey.
Hey.
Okay, this is going to be a fire cameo. Oh.
Whoa, dude. Is that Ace Blackberry?
I mean, basically.
Wow, you're like Tyler Perry or something, because, you know, you play your own characters.
I can't tell if you're a part of the demographic that would say that as a compliment or an insult.
Is that Reese? The one who's making a Christian short film? Reese is making a Christian short film?
Alright,
Oh my goodness, is that Reese Sorn?
I mean, basically.
Boy, what is going on here? Bro. You, for real? You my idol.
Ooh. Jesus should be your idol, kid.
Bro, you don't even know how much I love you. I have such a passion. Like, if you go to my room, there's, like, just this wall dedicated to you.
You say you had a wall?
I even ordered, don't get kicked out, but you're gonna get kicked out. But I even ordered, like, the big size pillow with your face on it. It's so beautiful, and I hug it and I cuddle it every night wishing it was you.
I'm gonna go pray.
Life comes in the forest and shakes. Look, you will see there.
Be the usual, one water.
Making a double, I'm going hard tonight.
All right. There's one. And two. You're an aquaholic.
Yeah, I can stop whenever I want. Bring me a third one.
Friends say we're really on and off again. That's not true, right?
No, BB.
I remember that summer eve. Since then I just can't think straight. Cause this girl's got a hold on me.
because, like, we'll start talking, get our ego fixes, then go off and date other people, get our hearts broken, come back to each other, get our ego fixes, go out and date other people, wash, rinse, repeat.
Well, then maybe we should stay together this time, baby.
I love you.
I love you too, baby.
Oh, you really bought that, huh?
But when you're famous, I'm gonna love you for your money.
You know, the messed up part is that you actually said that to me in 2014. Not joking. Lizzie and I broke up pretty much right after that because I still wasn't happy. I'm stuck between reality and fantasy with no clear distinction between the two.
Yo, why my head so big, man?
Nobody should have to suffer from cosmic awareness. God is making me suffer by letting me live.
Why? Why?
Ooh, I could use that during the finale of the movie. Yeah, okay. And yes, I am using a lot of stock music and stock footage in Lukewarm Christian. But it doesn't really matter if this movie's cheap because it's still going to be good. Imagine how embarrassed PureFlix is going to be when some 21-year-old from Iowa made a better movie than them with just a $3,000 budget as opposed to their $1 to $3 million budget.
My gosh! Can you see your colon yet? Go away, humility, I don't need you.
Seriously, you need to humble yourself, my guy.
No, because unlike all these famous YouTubers who've made movies, and apparently PureFlix too, I've actually taken acting classes, and I've read a screenplay writing book. Not only that, but I also have a college degree in film, so I actually know what I'm doing. Obviously, I'm going to make the better film.
Ego? Minimize. Fit? Pride cometh before the fall, okay? Nobody likes an arrogant blowhard. No need to act like you're famous before you get famous, okay? Just chill. Listen to my fitticism.
You know, I'm basically the Don Quixote of Christian movie protagonists. Like, this is probably one of the only Christian movies where the main character is genuinely insane. I'm basically a cynical subversion of all those vain and empty movies about faith, while providing a genuinely new take on the genre. It's gonna be revolutionary.
It's for you.
Thanks, Edgar. Right? Hello? What's that? This 10-minute segment in the movie is lazy exposition?
I am insane. This isn't part of the act. There's something wrong in my brain. The part that feels pride is always an overdrive, but the part that feels empathy is completely empty, yeah.
Okay, let's get something straight. This is a script, not a diary. I know I'm gonna be rich and famous one day, but for now I'm stuck in Iowa with a bunch of
educated individuals that I respect on a spiritual level.
Now, you're probably wondering how a 21-year-old is able to make such intelligent allegories in such a cheap and independent movie. Here's my secret. Think of me as a guitar. The only reason you can hear me is because someone's pulling my strings. Now, they say Lucifer was the music director in heaven, so you know he likes a little tune. God and Satan coexist in all of us. Who's pulling your strings? Let's let that sink in. Oh boy. I write my own jokes, if you couldn't tell.
This is my new pet, Harvey Swinstein. Nah, I'm just kidding, it's a girl. Her name's Amy Schumer.
So, they say in order to be famous in Hollywood, you have to sell your soul. Like, they say you have to compromise who you are in order to be famous. And, if you have to sell your soul to be famous, why are there so many redheaded celebrities in Hollywood? Hey, would you look at that? Reese Thorne texted me, begging me to come home. Sorry, Reese. I'm too scared to come home. I'm homophobic. I've been really messed up ever since I encountered that Bill Cipher ripoff. It told me I could have everything I've ever wanted if I just took a bite. Who knew the forbidden fruit would have such a Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde effect on my brain? I think it might have given me a very rare disease called Kuru. But that can't be the case, otherwise I'd be dead, right? How am I not dead? Looks good, right? Oh my gosh, what have I done? What have I done? I just ruined the continuity for this entire movie because I'm shooting everything out of order. One thing I've noticed about Reese is that he is obsessed with breaking the fourth wall. I mean, like, personally, meta-humor is my favorite type of comedy, but clearly Reese thinks that he's above conventional film structure to be breaking the fourth wall on this level. Hey! You guys want to see some symbolism? You think I'm a good person in real life? Yeet! Oh, think again! How do you make a war room again?
What are you doing, my sweet peanut butter prince?
I made a war room. From the movie War Room. Praying that Fit will come back. Honestly, I just kind of feel like this is all my fault because I forced Fit to come to church when he didn't want to go. And I'm finding it very difficult to forgive myself. He doesn't answer any of my calls. He doesn't reply to my texts. I don't know if he's showering wherever he is. Probably not. He's probably eating candy. He's probably not eating healthy wherever he is. Einar told me he saw him at the gas station buying candy. So I know he's okay. He's just not... He's like ignoring me.
Oh, my Reese peanut butter cup. It's not your fault. Fit is hardening his heart. He'll have to come back home on his own. We cannot force him to return.
That's the smartest thing you've ever said, Ariana.
I know. Now let's go spend some time together.
Well, doesn't that kind of, you know, pull away from the main story?
Yay, but it's called a B-plot for a reason. Yeet.
Well, I guess this is a Christian film, so there's got to be multiple plots about multiple different characters that don't really tie in with each other.
Exactly.
All right. Let's boogie.
Oh, oh. Oh, oh. You gotta listen up, listen up. There's not a thing that I can get from you. Boy, I don't need that much, need that much. How can I tell you what I wanna do? I never needed you to give me things. I never needed gifts or diamond rings. All I ever need, I need, I. All I ever need is here with you. There's a place where we can go, where it's all shining like the stars.
Nothing over a dollar.
Don't ever let me be away from you. I'm gonna hold it tight, hold it tight.
Here I come! Ariana, I have fully immersed myself into a solipsistic world that no sane person can enter. This movie's absurd for a reason. Who knew 5 months of isolation would eventually manifest itself into borderline sociopathy? Maybe I should hit up Shane Dawson to do a series. I'm starting to feel like the Blackheath Ledger. To paraphrase what Friedrich Nietzsche once said, if you gaze long enough into the abyss will eventually gaze back at you. It won't be long before I finally have to accept reality and allow myself to sink into a pool of nihilism. Even though I accepted reality, I became content. Because I was free. Hashtag foreshadowing. I've been surviving on ramen noodles and snails that make their way into my car for the last 5 months. I used to get sleep paralysis all the time because I kept rejecting the spirits that were trying to enter my body. I eventually went crazy trying to fight them off, but once I finally let them in, my sleep paralysis stopped. Yuzugal has gone from goofy and lighthearted to incredibly dark and meta.
When did we have to get so dark and meta? I miss the old Yuzugal.
I no longer make jokes just to make them. I now make jokes at the expense of others as well as myself. I've become a cyberbully. Lukewarm Christian is as much of a Christian movie as Ren and Stimpy is a kid's show. It's an introspective retrospective. Did Reese intend for this movie to be an allegory for dissociative identity disorder? Because I seem to exhibit a lot of the symptoms of that disorder in this movie. Everyone around me thinks I've gone crazy, and I think they're right. Reese is trying to guilt trip me into coming back home. There's a lot of people who try to guilt trip me, and I mean, good luck, because you're basically trying to guilt trip someone who's essentially a corpse on the inside, or a cold-blooded reptile. It would be extremely hard to make me feel bad about anything. But on the plus side, I am extremely charming and can figure out how someone ticks just by having one conversation with them. And if I can't, then I avoid that person because they might be just like me. Unpredictably aloof. Now, cognitive empathy typically makes people think that I'm a decent person. You know, my self-awareness is a byproduct of high-functioning insanity. You know, I need to find a better purpose in my life than making niche content for a tiny cult fan base on YouTube. I need to find a better purpose in life. I think I'm gonna do it. All right, transition! No, not like that. Ugh.
Inside of a simulation. Wake up. Wake up.
Well, I hope you guys are enjoying Lukewarm Christian so far. But it's not really a Yuzugel film unless it has an overly long montage that adds nothing to the plot. So, without further ado, here is a compilation of skits where I try to find a better purpose in my life than turning to God. First purpose, become a magician. Oh yeah! Going through my head like a jet plane, going with the lights on, turns out it started with a fight tonight. Tristan! Get on our level, Skillet! Hello, everybody. I am Professor Kettlecorn. Welcome to composition class. You will be reading this book that I wrote myself. It is called The Screech Book. Here's a little rundown of what it's going to be like. So, yeah, it's pretty much just that for about 100 pages. Basically, it's just as useful as every other YouTuber book. Yep. Get started. Here, just pass that around, Jimmy. Where is it?
I'm looking for these, Reese. Why are you doing memes, Reese?
They're just Pepes, Mom.
Pepes are a gateway meme, Reese.
Well, fine. How about I go live with Dad, then?
Reese, I need to talk to you.
Yes, Dad?
Have you been doing memes?
Yeah.
Why?
Well, to be honest, I started doing memes because of you, Dad.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and move in with Grandpa. I know he'll be more accepting of my meme addiction than you and Mom. Ooh.
Hey, what you got there, Reese?
Memes?
Yeah. Back in my day, we didn't have memes.
We had drugs.
This was also originally filmed for meme dealers, too.
You are the hero this platform needs but doesn't deserve. You are the new wave.
Get on my level, Skillet. I just want to say, being able to win an award for a film about memes is a meme come true. This award, it helped my self-esteem and made me realize maybe I will be something someday, you know? Maybe I don't have to be so nihilistic. I mean, I'm not fully nihilistic. I still believe in God, but like this award really helps. You are all being brainwashed! Stop watching this movie while you have a chance. Nobody ever notices the subtleties in Yuzugal, which makes it easier to brainwash them with subliminal messages.
I'm a clone of Reese Thorne. The real Reese Thorne is dead.
There are tons of subliminal messages in this movie, okay? Tons of them. You need to leave. Get out while you still can. Everybody leave. Get out of my head! Ha! You're the only one without glasses! What a nerd! Ha ha! Two eyes! Oh, what a loser. Let's get this bread! Yeast! Nice! I'm in 2013, back when Yuzugal was in its prime, and then it peaked 3 years later. Let's go on a walk.
There, I just tweeted our whereabouts.
Wouldn't it make it easier for Ethan and Cal to find us?
Maybe, but it's not like they can stop us.
But how do you know?
I know because if Ace and Cal even try to stop us, I'll do this.
Oh, and by the way, the music playing in the background was by Epic Rap Battles of History. I love your guys' work. Please don't copyright strike us. Anyways, I'll see you guys in the next skit. I gotta get ready for my next cue. Yeet.
Please don't hurt me. Please don't hurt me.
Hey, look, man, I am so sorry, but like, I really want to be famous.
Please.
I don't know what it is, but I just had a thing for lizards lately.
It's also important to note that you should take anything I say about the Illuminati with a grain of salt as well, because the Illuminati has never been proven. They're just a conspiracy.
And conspiracies are just that. Conspiracies. They're not facts. They've never been proven. Conspiracies are just another form of gossip to distract us from Jesus Christ.
Argue with my new boss!
Please. Come on, Reese Thorne. Keep going.
Oh, I'm not even the real Reese Thorne. The real Reese Thorne is dead.
Yes, you're the reborn Reese Thorne, meant to perform and give your audience the entertainment that they deserve.
Please don't make me perform anymore. I don't want to perform for him anymore. It wasn't worth my soul.
Well, you should have thought about that before you signed an eternity contract. Now, do the Illuminati chant.
I don't want to do the Illuminati chant.
Ooga chunga chunga chunga, 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 ooga chunga
chunga chunga. Yes, this is what we are. That's what you are. You better keep us pleased, Mr. Thorne. Or there'll be a story in the media about how you died in a car crash while coincidentally having 28 bullet wounds in your back. Don't disappoint us, Mr. Thorne.
It wasn't worth my soul.
So, what you doing?
I'm catching them all, man.
It's funny because Pokemon exists. Bazinga.
Drink water or you die!
Feeling stinky? More! Even more! Ace Body Spray! It's shower in a can!
About going vegan, Reese, but have you ever thought about going vegan?
I'm thinking about taking your advice and at least going vegan for, like, trying to go vegan for a month.
This lasted milliseconds.
My gosh! This film is, like, super edgy. I mean, how far is Reese willing to go? Oh my all! Oh boy, I think this joke is actually gonna get Reese killed. He better not travel anywhere outside the US where ISIS will catch him lacking.
And let the fights begin.
Go! Yeah, go! Go little buddy! Go little buddy! Yeah.
Yes! That's hilarious.
Hey! What is this? You got a thing for feet now?
No, dude. I'm just holding her foot for the joke. It's a joke.
Yeah, okay, Tarantino.
Inner conflict.
Yeah, let's see how you like being a puppet.
Ah!
Okay.
Having power over another individual makes me feel so powerful.
Ah!
Oops. Wrong religion.
Just like that. Okay. Reese is no longer dead.
So, you're the new employee?
Yeah. Danae.
Danae. My name's Fit.
Finn?
No, like Fit with a T.
Oh, Fit.
Yep, yeah.
Do you have a girlfriend?
No. Do you have a girlfriend?
No.
Oh, thank God.
Fit!
Hey, Yo-Yo Jojo!
Ah, don't Yo-Yo Jojo me. Your Christian movie isn't a good representation of the Christian faith.
Well, my movie's a much more realistic take on Christianity than God's Not Dead.
Your Christian movie should be taking itself more seriously.
Well, yeah, you know, like, the whole point of this movie is to not take itself seriously. So many Christian movies do take themselves seriously, you know? Like I don't really like serious movies. Like, I don't want to be reminded of reality when I watch a movie. I watch movies to escape reality, you know?
You guys may not like the grim, realistic ending that I'm about to give you, because you don't like being reminded of reality when you're watching a movie. You like watching movies to escape reality.
I don't want to be reminded of reality when I watch a movie. I watch movies to escape reality, you know?
Because you don't like being reminded of reality when you're watching a movie. You like watching movies to escape reality.
I don't want to be reminded of reality when I watch a movie. I watch movies to escape reality, you know? Like, you know...
Your Christian movie is mocking God.
Hey, that does it! I am tired of you Christians telling me how to make my movie as if you've ever read a screenplay writing book or made a movie yourselves like you know what you're talking about.
All right. I'm sorry for what I said. Maybe I should have had a different approach.
Listen, it is my movie, and I can make it however I please! Do you understand me?
Alright, now you're kind of coming off as a narcissist that can't take criticism.
How dare you criticize me! I'm a prodigy! I'm a god!
I always knew I was a fucking
god! How dare you! Now, I know you wouldn't dare run. Because of the implication.
You ever hear of that movie, Adrenaline?
Yeah, I didn't like it that much.
Dude, you're in the minority.
Did someone say... minority? Bazinga.
Hey, what's an intelligent woman like you doing in a dumb movie like this?
Well, that didn't work out so well.
Oh, hey, yo, Bray, man, I can't believe it created that much smoke.
Yeah, man, most of it's from the fog machine, dude.
Hey! What you think you're doing?
Man, who you is?
I'm the weed whacker. I'm here to rid the world of marijuana. And I knew I smelled something today because it's... ...420. It's up to me and get scum like you off the streets.
Time to die, liberals!
Are you insane?
21?
Actually,
21,
yes.
21.
Listen, Natalie. You're the greatest girlfriend I've ever had. You listen to me. You never bring up other guys constantly to make me jealous like one of my exes did. And you make sure I take my ADHD medicine, which is why my mom loves you.
My nihilism goes away when you're around, because when you're around, I actually feel like I have a purpose in life.
Oh, you're so sweet.
Yeah. Also, I'm breaking up with you.
Sorry?
Yeah, you're a really nice girl, but like, you just remind me too much of my mom. You know, like, you give me lectures about wasting money on candy, you make me clean up after myself, you make me wash myself, and that's no good. So, yeah.
So you just want me to let you get diabetes and be nasty?
Well, yeah.
You need to grow up. I don't want to be with some 21-year-old who has the mentality of a 5-year-old.
Well, don't worry then, because we're done.
We're literally perfect for each other. How often do you find a woman who likes George Carlin? How often do you find a woman who likes Bill Hicks? How often do you find a woman who likes Sam Hyde? How often do you find a woman who actually knows who those three guys are?
You present some very strong arguments, but the part in my brain that feels pride isn't gonna let me stand down, so...
Hey, high five? Hey, Natalie! Jesus, man!
Hey, I know, witchcraft is considered a bit taboo in Christianity, but how else am I supposed to make a woman love me?
You want a drink? There you go. It's not a love potion.
Are you sure this isn't a love potion?
Wait, actually, thanks. On second thought, I just realized there's something a bit creepy about giving a drink to an unsuspecting victim to make her fall in love with me without her consent, and I ain't trying to be the next Bill Cosby, you feel me?
Hey guys, I just found something better than a love potion. I message a girl first, wait for her to reply, and ignore her for 5 minutes to make her love me. Oh man, I just wrote this new script. It's so subtle, no one's gonna know it's based on me.
AMC Theater, this is Frank. How can I help you?
Hey, Frank? I turned in, this is Fit Kettlecorn, by the way. I turned in a job application a few weeks ago. I was wanting to know if you got it or not.
Yeah, Fit, I got your application right here.
Did you just rip my application?
No. Gosh, no.
Hey, look. You guys like it? I call it Dadaism.
Hello, my fellow Americans. I'm Barack Obama. And today I want to talk about Obamacare. You see, I
couldn't find a black actor.
Hey, excuse me, waiter. I realize this is a private restaurant that only celebrities get to eat at, so that's why I feel so honored to eat here despite not being a celebrity yet. But, I gotta ask, why is the menu just a bunch of missing posters? Who is that?
Wow! I finally achieved my dreams! I've made it! What'd they do to deserve that? Ooh, I better look away before I turn into a pillar of salt.
Alright guys, looks like we're getting a Netflix adaptation.
Oh, yay!
I have some concerns.
Also, why am I white?
Ooh, she has a kid. Left swipe. Ooh, that's a cigarette.
left swipe dat? Ooh, she looks mentally unstable.
So you know how to work the register?
Yeah, I got everything. Thanks.
All right. Yep. Got it. Yep.
It's not ringing up.
Well, I guess I get it for free then. What, you don't have a sense of humor?
No, I have a sense of humor. That's why I didn't laugh. 1776 is your total. 1776. 1776.
1776. 1776.
1776 is your total.
That's a little expensive for a banana, don't you think?
Well, yeah, it's a convenience store.
Ah, forget this.
Hey, how you doing today?
I had gas.
What pump?
Pump 9.
Okay, that'll be $20.43. Thank you.
Oh wait, I have 43 cents.
Okay.
Hi, I'm Adam.
And I'm Steve.
And we were wondering if you could bake us a cake for a very special occasion.
Okay. Oh, geez, that montage was a lot longer than I anticipated. But despite that series of non sequiturs, I still couldn't really find any meaning or purpose in my life. I wasn't happy. I'm starting to think that life really is meaningless. I mean, like, they say like, life is meaningless, but you can also add meaning to it. But during, like, not once during those that compilation of skits did I find purpose and was satisfied. You could add meaning to your life, but, like, you have to keep a grip on reality and accept that no matter what purpose you, no matter what you're living for, it's, life is still meaningless. Life is still meaningless. And you could cut that entire compilation of skits out of the video, out of the movie, and it wouldn't even make a single difference on the narrative. Heck, you could cut anything out of this movie, and it probably wouldn't make a difference on the narrative. My life is a series of non sequiturs. It's just a bunch of different events that don't tie in with each other. It's completely meaningless. Life doesn't make narrative sense. Crazy Ex-Girlfriend, love that show. Well, either way, I gotta stay positive. I'm gonna go get something to eat. Hi, I'm Jimmy Fatella Kettlecorn, and you're watching my Christian channel.
What is the meaning of life? What
is the point of life if God's just going to burn everything in the end? What's the point in creating art if it's all going to perish in the end? Because art is really the only thing I can do, and like, if it's all just going to perish in the end, why am I creating art? Why am I here? Like, the Bible says that we are all put here to spread the gospel so we can get as many people into heaven as possible, but like, is that our only purpose here on this earth? Like, why not just create humanity and automatically place them into heaven? Why do we have to go through all of this suffering here on earth? Like, life is meaningless. As a matter of fact, the Bible even says that life is meaningless. Ecclesiastes says everything is meaningless. The words of the teacher, son of David, king in Jerusalem. Meaningless, says the teacher. Utterly meaningless. Everything is meaningless. What do people gain from all their labors at which they toil under the sun? Generations come and generations go, but the earth remains forever. And then if you skip all the way down to the bottom, what has been will be again. What has been done will be done again. There is nothing new under the sun. Is there anything of which one can say, look, this is something new? It was here already, long ago. It was here before our time. No one remembers the former generations, and even those yet to come will not be remembered by those who follow them. Right there in the Bible, it states that there is no such thing as originality, and everybody will be forgotten at a certain point in time. The next one, like Ecclesiastes 12, it says wisdom is meaningless. Ecclesiastes 18,
for with much wisdom comes much sorrow. The more knowledge, the more grief.
It says pleasures are meaningless. Toil is meaningless. Wisdom and folly are meaningless. It says advancement is meaningless. And it says riches are meaningless. So it doesn't matter if you're poor or if you're rich, you're still gonna die. It straight up admits it. The Bible admits that life is meaningless. Why are we here? Why am I here? Why are we here?
I have to escape this simulated reality. There's only one way. I know how.
I know all the atheists watching are waiting for me to say, God's not real. Because to them, a movie can't be this nihilistic without being anti-religion. But that's not the case. Because God is real. Otherwise, we wouldn't be in this much pain. Everything in this world feels a little too orchestrated to be summed up to evolution. Everything feels so planned. Did God not know Adam and Eve were going to eat that fruit and release sin into the world, causing pain, disease, and suffering? Are you telling me he didn't know? Guys, God is seeing the past, present, and future all at once because he wrote the story. Humanity was set up. We were meant to live in pain. And I'm about to ask him why.